Hey, good morning. It's Lynda Cromar coming to you from my home office in Colorado. I'm looking at a picture that was taken in our mountains at fall. I don't know what year it was, but it doesn't matter. I've got so many of these kind of pictures on hand that I really enjoy them. And what I want to talk about today goes right along with this picture, and it is about change. Nobody really likes to think about change, but it's happening momentarily to our bodies, to our minds, every single day. So we can decide either to make change something we embrace and something that we can actually control to some degree, or we can make it something that we are a victim of. Well, you can just about imagine what my thoughts are on that. My thoughts are that obviously we need to be in control as much as we possibly can. That means we become proactive and that we take our own responsibility and our own action to make that change something that is beneficial instead of something that hurts us in some way. So just like this picture shows us that the aspens have turned yellow, meaning that very shortly they will lose their leaves and winter will be upon us. And that's also true right now in our own world. Anyone that lives in an area where there is a winter time, a true winter time, will see this happen as well. If you're not in the mountains, it doesn't matter because you're going to see this probably through this month and all the way up through November. You're going to see the leaves change. That's just the way it works in this world. Our seasons change and we have to adapt. And that's the same thing that happens for our own lives and what we want to do in our lives. We have to make a decision that we are going to change in good ways instead of bad ways. In other words, yes, you can let sickness overtake your body, or you can proactively go and find ways to improve your health. You can take actions like walking and eating correctly, and those things all help to make your health better. Or you can choose to continue to use the bad habits in your life to let you eventually go to a point where your life is now not under your control. That's the same thing I do as far as my business as well. I take action and I build my business with my own ingenuity. I can't say that word for some reason. My own grit, my own action, my own desire, I use all of that to my advantage so that when changes happen, I am prepared. Like for instance, I spent a couple of weeks kind of having a little bit of a battle with my family members about what's going to happen to my husband when he dies. I wanted to have a cremation because it's less money and it's a lot more simple. Many of the other family members did not like that idea and they wanted a burial. So instead of becoming a victim, I found a solution. And so I'm going to be acting on that this week. You have the opportunity to do that for anything that comes up in your life, whether it's a personal matter or whether it is a business matter. For instance, many people are thinking, well, I can't buy leads, so I can't build my business. Well, that's the only one way that you can build your business. I have always been more successful with building my business on social media by just learning to talk to people, and I do that on a daily basis. If you want to understand more about that, you might want to talk to me. But this is what I want to share today. Business or personal, change is going to happen, and you have to decide whether or not you're going to make it something you can control or something that controls you. That's what I have to share with you today. If you found this of any value, please give it a like, give it a comment, more than just I agree, of course, something that's valuable, and please share so that other people can have the opportunity to learn from me. And also, if you want to learn more about what I do to build my business, you need to give me a comment that you would like to know more, and then we'll be getting in touch. Bye for now.